Hello everyone, in this tutorial I will show you how to make this fur material using parallax occlusion mapping. This was a request from Blend Space Lab. I might make a better one later in the future. So this is all I have right now. So to make this you need two textures. First one is the height and the second one is the texture. I made both of them in Substance Designer. So this is a fluid noise texture you get from the noise tab. So you get that from here. So this is a fluid one and this is a fur one. So I just increase the level a bit, then blend them both together and inputted them into the height map. And for the fur, I just used a gradient map and changed the color a bit and inputted it into the base color. Then I exported it out and imported it into the Unreal Engine. So we are going to use parallax occlusion mapping to make this fur. So the first thing you need to do is create a material. So for that, right click and click on material. I will name this fur.mat, fur underscore mat. Then open it up. Then drag and drop the height texture. Then drag and drop the fur texture. We need to duplicate the height texture two times. Now I will convert this to a texture object. Now we will right click and type in parallax occlusion mapping. So we get this node. First we are going to input this into the height map texture. First, input this into the height map texture. Then we have to do something here. So here you can see height map channel. Since we have a grayscale image, all the channels will be our height map except the alpha. So if I check blue, you can see all of this channel has the same image because we have a grayscale image. So we need to input a vector 4 here. So for that, press and hold 4 and click. So and connect this here. So we can either change 1 for, we can give 1 for R or G or B to select the channel with the height map is in. This is if we use packed textures, then the red channel might have the height texture, the blue channel might have the roughness map, and the green channel might have ambient occlusion. But we are not using packed textures here. So R, G and B all have our height map. So just give one to any one of them. Now we need to create a couple of parameters. We need 3. So hold S and click 3 times. I will name this height ratio. And I will name this min steps. And I will name this max steps. And I will connect height ratio to height ratio and give it a default value of 0.2. And for the min step, I will connect this to min step and give it a default value of 25. And now I connect the max step to the max step and give it a default value of 120. I will show you later what these three things do. Now we will give a texture coordinate. So for that, press and hold U and click, so we get this texture coordinate. Now press and hold M and click, so we get this multiply, and connect this to the multiply and connect this to UVs. Now we will create a new scalar. So press and hold X and click, so we get this scalar parameter, and I will name this tiling, and I will get a default value of 1, and I will connect this to B. Now I will convert this to a texture object. We need a normal map, and I could just create the normal map from the substance designer, but I decided not to. I will show you a trick to create normal map from the height map. So convert the height map texture to a texture object. So right click and type in normal from height map, and connect this to the height map T2D, and then we will copy this or duplicate this by pressing Ctrl and W, and connect this to the height map channel selector. If we preview this, you can see the normal map. I will connect this to the normal map. Then from here, the pixel depth offset goes to the pixel depth offset here, and I will give it a value, and I will give a roughness a value of 0.9, so it is very rough. Now I'm going to connect this parallax UVs to this, and also to the coordinate of our normal from height map. Then I will add a hue. So right click and type in hue. So we get this hue shift. Connect the texture here and connect this to the base color, so we can change the color later. So we need to add a new parameter here. So press and hold S and click, so we get this parameter and connect this here. I will name this hue. Then we need to add the rim lighting effect. So for that, we will use a Fresnel node. So right click and type in Fresnel, and we will lerp. So press and hold L and click, so we get this lerp, and connect the alpha to the Fresnel to the alpha, and connect this to base color, and connect this on top. And for B, we will give a white color. So press and hold 3 and click, so we get this 3 vector. And I will convert this to a parameter, and I will call it rim color. So we can change the color later. So I will give it a value of white. Then we need to control this rim width, or like this radius. So we need to create a new parameter. So press and hold S and click, and connect this to exponent, and I will name this Fresnel. And I will give it a value of 15. So as you can see, as a decrease the value, it became the white color will move towards the center, and I increase the value, we have a very thin layer of white color in the edge, on the edge. So I think that's what we need to do here. So one thing you have to keep in mind that when we increase the tiling here, this tiling also increases. There is a way to fix that. I will show that in a future video. So click apply and save. Then I will drag and drop a sphere in. And then I will create a material instance. So right click and create material instance. Apply this to the sphere. So you can see the artifacts, but if I play, the artifacts won't be there. So you don't have to mind the artifacts. So you can actually change the parameters. So open it up. And I will give it a nice rim color. So I will change the height ratio a bit. So as you can see, it will get a bit longer. It looks a bit longer. You can also change the tiling so we get finer fur. And then you can play around with the maximum min flow to get the look you want. You can change the color by selecting the hue and changing it. So you can see artifacts in the editor, but if I press play, it won't be there. So this fur material tends to do well on curved surfaces. On flat surfaces there is some issue. I will try to make a better fur material later. So this is all I have now. I hope you enjoyed it. So thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this.